On the news hour tonight, we're taking up a difficult subject, deliberately so, because I think it's time to talk about it. I think it's time to be free and frank about it, and I think it's time to also stop being preachy about it. Especially, I began today by saying this, that today, this Diwali is a difficult Diwali for most Indians. देश भर में लोगों को इस बार दिवाली में बहुत मतलब उन्हें लग रहा है कि ये बहुत डिफिकल्ट दिवाली है, मुश्किल दिवाली है. लोगों पीपल हैव नॉट गॉट देयर बोनसेस, सम पीपल आर लूजिंग देयर जॉब्स, यू नो पीपल आर गेटिंग देयर सैलरीज. इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट दिवाली एंड इन दिस दिवाली आई थिंक वी ऑल बिगिन बाय अग्रींग दैट पीपल हैव अ राइट टू नो कि पॉलिटिशियंस के पास इतना पैसा कहाँ से आता है. हाउ डू पॉलिटिशियंस गेट सो मच मनी? That's a simple, straightforward question. And I'm not saying any one politician. I'm saying all politicians. The political parties across the board are going to spend a lot of money in this election. We want to know where this money is coming from. So, let me welcome on the News Hour debate tonight. And I'm putting that question to you as well, dear News Hour viewer. My question to you is on News Hour, I have a question. Do you think all these political parties, before pointing fingers at each other, should first say, we will be open to coming under the Right to Information Act? And then let's ask these questions. Kumar Vishwas of the Aam Aadmi Party. Sabir Ali with me in the studio representing the JDU. He says, yes, I want to know where Modi is getting his money from. Jay Narayan Vyas of the BJP. Professor R. Vaidyanathan, professor of IIM Bangalore. He leans towards the right. Sanjay Jha of the Congress Party and GVL Narasimha Rao. My first question is to you. Kapil Sibal has said, and by the way, GVL Narasimha Rao is member of the BJP's National Committee on Electoral Reforms. If we want electoral reforms, the first thing we need is that we need clean funding of elections. So, GVL Narasimha Rao, your response to Kapil Sibal, who says today, he says 10 to 15 crore is spent on each stadium. It should be investigated as to what kind of money is used to fund these rallies.
I think all parties will be open to declare all details, but let Congress party, before making these allegations, all these allegations, let them come out transparently and then say how are they ferrying people to listen to their leaders' rallies, how much money are they spending in terms of transportation, how much money are they paying as fees or wages to people to listen to their leaders. In fact, Mr. Modi's rallies, no money is spent by the party in terms of mobilizing crowds. And no money is spent on giving any wages or food or anything. It's only for the minimal arrangements of the stage and etc. is what the party spends money on. And that's not big deal. And the Congress party seems to have completely run out of issues.
So you're not spending. First of all, I'm making an exception. I want to say to the viewer tonight, one second.
The party would be willing to put out all information. GVL, but let them also be transparent.
GVL Narasimha Rao, one point I want to say tonight, that I am going for the open debate style tonight. If you agree with me, with all our participants, open debate means you are free to jump into the debate. I'm not going through introductory points. Therefore, we are getting into straight interjections from the top. I only asked the first question. Sabir Ali wants to immediately interject. Sabir Ali wants to interject.
Mr. Rao has been arranged any time.
I have gone
close to the rallies, how the BJP people are gathering the people. They are providing food. They are providing shuttles. They are providing each and every one. They are paying the money. And there is evidence. And they are gathering. Apart from all,
people just see the stage.
And the pandals, it's like five-star, like they are celebrating marriages. And never happened in the, at least in the any public rally of any political party, which has been initiated by the BJP. It's really ridiculous, and you are saying, because I know you are, of course, you have all idea to how to manage the table. You have not idea, you have not gone to the field to arrange the people. They are doing it. BJP people, they
know
how much they are paying.
This Kapil Sibal
putting these allegations, he was hesitated. I think this is all one rally minimum, they are costing more than 50 crores.
I'm not.
Absolutely.
One rally, 50 crores?
Minimum. That's the minimum.
Tell me how you come to that number. No, let me prove it now. How do you come to that number?
I'm just telling you.
How can you prove it?
The stage, the mic system, the pandals, and the bringing the people, they are paying for food, even for the whole day's wages and the buses, air-conditioned buses, all these costs. calculate.
If 50 crores is a lot of money.
1 lakh people.
People are giving.
Do you have personal experience? One second. On a lighter note, do you have arranged rallies like that?
I'm telling you, my party is the smaller party.
Do you have personal experience of organizing rallies?
I don't mind to accept that we do provide the shuttles and that we have to pay for. But there, our stage is totally a simple stage, put on the stones, or if there is any ready-made. Today, the last in Bihar, has never happened that the stage has been imported from Delhi.
Now, this the vice
president. So it has cost.
The vice president of the Delhi BJP says, 1 minute, please. Please don't. First of all, I think I have a right to ask this question. Vice president of Delhi BJP recently made a point. He says, we will install 100 LED screens across the country for live telecast of speeches. 100 LED screens, each of them 6 feet into 8 feet. Jainarayan Vyas, 6 feet into 8 feet, 100 LED screens in markets, railway stations, interstate bus terminus. Is this also happening for free? I mean, where's the money coming from, Mr. Vyas? Is this normal?
Well, yes. Arnab, the parties also have their own funds and these funds are audited. It is for the election commission also to audit these expenses. And it is not totally everything that goes under cover. If Rahul Gandhi can be issued a warning for not being in line with the code of conduct, don't think that all these fairy tale which is being stories which are being mentioned can go
stage
out from the
eyes
of the election commission.
More than a
they
crore,
trained,
like a marriage ceremony.
Income tax officers,
even any bigger person
from
cannot
Revenue Services.
Decorate that kind of
income
stage.
Tax officers
has never happened in any political party.
Who are monitoring
the
expenses and
stage
who are having
still
full powers.
If how much money has been
no. It is not 50 rupees you are saying, it is 500 rupees, they will book 500 rupees to your account. What else you want?
Well, I don't know. First of all, I have not said any party. No, please understand one thing, Mr. Vyas. I have not said any party is... I have said today, I remember everything. Please remember this.
Please
remember this. The Congress also, Kumar Vishwas will bear me out.
You always do.
Kumar Vishwas, the Congress has also been at the receiving end of such allegations. I think Kejriwal questioned the source of a mega rally in 2012. Do I know where that money came from? Do I know who is funding Congress party rallies? Kumar Vishwas, kya aapko sawal ka jawab mila tha? Jab when Congress held a massive rally at Ramlila Maidan, Arvind Kejriwal in November 2012, you may remember, and asked, where did the money come from? How did you transport the people? How did you get people on special trains? Was any incentive in cash given to the people attending the rally? Did the Congress party make the accounts public? No. It didn't. Did it, Kumar?
जवाब नहीं मिला इसीलिए शायद हम जवाब तलाशने के लिए खुद आगे बढ़े हैं. मेरे को दो तीन बातें कहनी है और माननीय पार्टी के महान नेता इसमें बीच में नहीं बोलेंगे ऐसी मैं उम्मीद करता हूं. जो सामने डाटा है 2,365 करोड़ रुपए तो कांग्रेस के पास है, 1,304 भाजपा के पास है. 82.5% कांग्रेस कहती है कि हमें पता नहीं कौन दे गया और भाजपा कहती है 73% हमें पता नहीं कौन दे गया. आप बहुत लोकप्रिय हैं, मैं आपके हार्डकोर फैंस और हार्डकोर निंदकों को जानता हूं. आज तक कोई फैन आपकी जेब में 100 रुपए नहीं डाल गया होगा कि अर्नब आप बहुत कमाल का शो करते हैं, भारत का टॉप नॉच शो है, ये मेरी मोहब्बत है आपके लिए. मैं भी बहुत पुराना शायर हूं, बहुत सारे मंचों पर गया हूं, मुझे भी आज तक कोई 100 रुपए नहीं देगा. मैं जिस जगह से आया हूं उसके तीन खेत दूर मायावती जी ने पॉलिटिक्स शुरू करी और मायावती जी के पास आज 500 करोड़ है जिसको बंद कर दिया सीबीआई ने, उनकी संपत्ति भी और पार्टी की भी. उन्होंने कहा लोगों ने प्रेम दे दिया. अब हमारे सारे मित्र कहेंगे, जनरल व्यास कहेंगे कि इनको विदेश से पैसा मिल रहा है. मैंने बार बार कहा है कि एक डॉलर भी अगर आप दिखा दें जो हमें किसी ने ऐसे आदमी ने दिया और जिसके पास
जनरल व्यास
हो, हमें आज तक 17 करोड़ रुपए मिला है जिसमें 32.3 करोड़ रुपया दिल्ली वालों ने दिया है. और हम बार बार कह रहे हैं कि जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट कह रहा है तो आप आरटीआई के अंडर में क्यों नहीं आना चाहते हैं. मुझे खुशी होगी कि साबिर अली साहब की पार्टी, भाजपा, बसपा, सपा, कांग्रेस, ये सब मिलकर आज के बाद कहें कि जो पैसा हमारे पास अननोन सोर्सेज से है उसे हम देश को दे देते हैं, प्रधानमंत्री रक्षा कोष में दे देते हैं शहीदों के लिए. और आज के बाद हम एक रुपया भी लेंगे तो पूछ के लेंगे. दूसरी बात, नेशनल पार्टीज का बड़ा खर्चा है हेलीकॉप्टर वाला, वो कभी कवर नहीं होता है.
कुमार विश्वास साहब
जी, अगर हमारे जयनारायण व्यास जी को बोलने दीजिए, जयनारायण व्यास जी को जयनारायण व्यास
आपके तजुर्बे को, कुमार विश्वास साहब मैं आपके तजुर्बे को सलाम करता हूं, मैं आपके तजुर्बे को सलाम करता हूं. 6 महीने में दिल्ली बेस्ड रह के आपने 70 करोड़ रुपए जमा कर लिए. ये अगर आपका तजुर्बा है तो कांग्रेस और भाजपा दोनों पार्टियां तो
वेबसाइट पर लगा हुआ है, आप भी देख लीजिए,
नेशनल पार्टीज हैं,
17 करोड़ रुपया वेबसाइट पर देख लीजिए। मैं तो पूछ रहा हूं, हमने तो बता रखा है किसने दिया है। देखिए आप पैसा डालिए आपको पता चल जाएगा, लेकिन मैं आप क्या डालता हूं मुझे पता ही नहीं चलता। इनको नहीं पता, इन्होंने लिख कर दिया है 82.5% पता नहीं है कांग्रेस को, 73% भाजपा को पता नहीं है कि कौन दे गया, ये कौन अच्छे लोग हैं जो इनका इतना पैसा दे जाते हैं।
मेरी और आपकी चर्चा का विषय नहीं है, अगर ट्रस्ट रजिस्टर हुआ है
28 तारीख को अन्ना आंदोलन के बाद 28 तारीख को मेरे घर इनकम टैक्स भेज सकते हैं संजय झा, तो उनकी पार्टी क्यों नहीं बताती कि उनके पास ये 2,500 करोड़ कौन देकर गया है। एक आम आदमी को आप सैलरी रोक देते हैं जनवरी के बाद अगर उसने इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न नहीं भरा है, आप भी बताइए कौन दे गया है। भाजपा के कहते हैं चाय की दुकान
थोड़ी है,
कांग्रेस वाले कहते हैं 82% कौन दे गया, हम बताएं कैसे।
नहीं नहीं द क्वेश्चन इज वेरी गुड, One second, the question is very good. The Congress party asked that where is the money coming from? But then, where is the money of any party coming from? 75% of the funds of parties who are opposed to coming under the Right to Information Act are coming from unknown sources. Sanjay Jha, am I correct? That includes the Congress.
Let me answer your question, Arnab, very quickly. Number one, because you started the discussion because Mr. Kapil Sibal has definitely made an allegation that the, you know, humongous public drama and the razzmatazz that you're seeing all across the country is well organized, clearly is very, very extremely strongly funded. And, you know, considering the Bharatiya Janata Party in Hyderabad very recently charged 5 rupees from an ordinary individual attending his rally, and it was told that that money will be donated for the Uttarakhand relief package, then let me tell you, I would assume that the BJP doesn't have too much of money. So the question that somebody will have to ask is, where is the BJP getting his massive source of funds from? That's point number one. Point number two, to answer Kumar Vishwas, let me tell you, Mr. Vishwas, I don't want to get into a slugfest with you, but there have been serious allegations against your own party members when they were part of an NGO before they became a political party, where they did not even offer receipts, cash was moving around in sacks, and we know why Anna Hazare therefore switched off from the movement. So please don't give any self-righteous lectures. Point number three, as far as, and Arnab, to answer your question, I know this is an open debate, but it doesn't have to be, you know, it doesn't have to be some kind of a ridiculous format, because the Aam Aadmi Party is on the debate.
Why they are giving so much money to you? Okay, come into the RTI ambit, Mr. Sanjay Jha. Have got
it. I'm answering your question.
Now confess it on
Arnab. Mr. Vishwas, this is not a sammelan of poets.
Arnab.
So please don't raise your voice. Let me answer
question. No, it's not a sammelan.
After you are free
don't
to
try to repeat
Sanjay,
all
please just
these
give
words.
Me a second. I won't take too long.
The point,
Mr. Vishwas, that I'm making.
Can you just let me finish? Congress Chamtagiri Shiver bhi nahi hai.
Sanjay Jha, 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. You see 1 minute.
About kabhi sammelan.
One second. First of all, the limited point being made is that in my Sanjay Jha, Sanjay Jha,
you guys are scandalous and a shame.
Sanjay Jha,
the way you communicate with the people,
Sanjay Jha,
the way you have insulted, can you
can you both please stay on the subject of the debate and let us not get personal. I'm genuinely requesting you, please.
Your party should be called the anarchist.
I'm genuinely requesting you, please. Now 1 minute, just come.
They are talking about movement.
Okay.
And Anna Hazare.
Okay, 1 minute, please. Now I'm requesting Sanjay Jha first, and after that I'm requesting you to Dr. Kumar Vishwas. Please let us bring our tempers down. You can debate as much as you want, but you remain on the focus. You see, the problem is that I am not talking about this party or that party. All I am taking is a larger point. A larger point is that let all parties open up. Only then do political parties have a right to make a moral issue of funding. Yes. Today, can any political party make a moral issue of funding? 90.38%.
Can I answer your question?
No, 1 second. 90.38% of the funds of one of the biggest political parties in the country between 2008 and 2012 are in cash. 9% are in check. And sorry, for the BJP also, 2/3 of the funds are in cash. For the NCP, 83% of the funds are in cash. 83%? Out of every rupee you get, 83 paisa are in cash. and then we say, why are we becoming a cash economy? So please, let's be very honest here today. And I'm saying this because people are having a difficult Diwali. When people of this country are having a difficult Diwali, we have a right to ask those questions. I'm getting Professor Vaidyanathan into the debate. Without getting personal, without only finger pointing, let's narrow it down. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I'm opening the questions in a minute. Professor Vaidyanathan.
Thank you, Arnav. I thought you are going to keep me as a 12th man in the cricket team.
No, certainly not. I'm sorry you were not the opening batsman. Yes. There's nothing personal.
This whole debate is turning to be surreal, actually.
Why?
Last what I heard is Kapil Sibal is the law minister of this country.
Yes.
And the Congress is the ruling party.
Yes.
If he has any suspicion or surmise that black money is getting used for rallies, he must inform the Income Tax Department, Enforcement Directorate, as well as SIFO. Mm. Has he done that?
Now, what is
he in the opposition or is he in the ruling? You know, the whole debate looks funny to me, actually, because the ruling party made the opposition as if they are the ruling.
With you. He has got a right to ask the BJP to explain their position.
No, but why does he not ask the NCP?
He must first complain to the Income Tax Department.
Yes, Sanjay, 1 minute. Sanjay,
you are in the ruling.
Sanjay, my information is...
Arnab!
No, 1 minute, Sanjay.
Whoever is talking, ask them to understand what I am telling.
That is Sanjay Jha of the Congress party.
No, Arnab, I fully endorse Professor Vaidyanathan's view.
Let him speak for himself.
I fully endorse Professor Vaidyanathan's view.
Okay.
He is absolutely right. You are ruling. It is your responsibility to deliver good governance.
Let him finish. You are in ruling.
Now, it is your responsibility to ensure that the governance is delivered fairly and properly.
No, let me finish.
Mr. Kapil Sibal felt so, that there was some unaccounted money going into a particular activity, he is armed with Directorate of Intelligence.
He is armed with the Income Tax Department. Dr. Vyas.
Without telling them, without complaining, since you appreciate, he goes to the media and talks something which is out of his immediate.
First of all, one minute. Please.
This is unbecoming of a minister.
First of all, Professor, I request you, Jainarayan Vyas, not to interrupt the person whose points you are appreciating. That's one. The person whose points you are appreciating.
You said it is free for all, Arnab. Now you are changing the rules of the game.
I am not. Sir, 1 second. There is a difference between an open debate and a free for all. If you think an open debate is a free for all, there's a slight difference between the two. After the debate, I'll call you up and I'll tell you.
The way you conducted, it was free for all.
No, please. If you want to make it a free for all, I'll stop you from making it a free for all. Now, please complete your point, Professor Vaidyanathan. By the way, Congress party tops the list of parties getting 1,951.07 crore rupees or 82.5% in anonymous donations. That's all. I'm just making a point, Professor.
Most important, I think the most important thing which is forgive.
If you
as the question goes to Professor Vaidyanathan, then you debate it.
I want to finish.
Let him finish the debate. Let him finish his point. Then you can come
back. I want to finish.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. Fair enough.
Kapil Sibal must resign because he has completely abdicated his responsibility as the legal minister of this country. First, he should go to the income tax and file a complaint. Not behave like a Dehati Aurat. Coming to the press.
Let's keep it civilized tonight, sir. Let's not get personal, sir.
No, I would like to.
Arnab, let me tell you.
You cannot stop me.
I am not stopping you. I am just requesting you not to make it personal.
I think I'm going to tell you. You have not been fair to the viewers of NewsHour. You need to tell the people of people watching news are that Mr. Vaidyanathan is clearly wearing a saffron hat or whatever else. He is clearly biased. It is very obvious.
No hat or anything. I must be allowed to finish.
That he is politically biased. I am not allowed to finish. Let him disprove it.
No, one second. I'm putting audio down for 30 seconds. Everyone's audio down for 30 seconds. 1 second. 30 seconds. Aam Aadmi Party, 1 second. 30 seconds. 1 minute. 1 minute. I want to counter that. Because Sanjay Jha says, I am not being fair to the viewers of NewsHour. Sanjay Jha, to you and every NewsHour viewer. I want to begin by saying, the NewsHour viewer, I am never unfair to the viewer. I began the debate by saying that he is a professor at IIM Bangalore who leans to the right. And when I mean leans to the right, he leans to the BJP and leans to the right. So you heard that, please. Yeah, now let him complete.
No. I did not hear that.
I said that.
I
leaned to the right side.
But Mr. Vaidyanathan, let me tell you, Vaidyanathan is clearly...
First, Mr. Vaidyanathan should complete his point.
I will take that back. Thank you.
First, Mr. Vaidyanathan should complete his point.
I want to come in here.
After Mr. Vaidyanathan, let him complete. Please don't do this. Yeah.
Arnav, I lean to the right side. You should tell that.
No, I won't say that. Yeah.
See, one important thing, I have been observing election for 30 years.
Sanjay, please.
I have been watching election for 30 years. I have never seen the level of fervor, whether you like it or not. Huge amount of people are going to watch Modi.
Okay.
Whether it will convert into votes, we don't know.
I'm not asking about that. That's
for
not...
the November 17th rally. No, 17th rally in Bangalore, already 30,000 people are willing to pay 10 rupee. So the question is the large crowd automatically mean black money as Kapil Sibal tried to allege?
They are also getting the 100 rupees in envelope. The people who are willing to pay 10 rupees, they are getting 100 rupees.
Most important is,
Mr. Vaidyanathan, since you are a professor at IIM Bangalore, can you multiply 5 by a crowd of 50,000?
People who are turning out the aggregate and amount paying of 10 rupees, they have already
and can you
are
tell
getting
me 2,50,000
rupees in envelope.
The rally. There are basic and fundamentals, professor. Let's not get into a spin here. 5
Sibal
rupees for 50,000
is responsibility.
Comes to 1,50,000 rupees.
Posturous,
absurd, and in my opinion, incongruous.
First caller, I'm taking the first caller in 30 seconds. No, 1 second. I say one thing. This is an austere Diwali. No, this is an austere Diwali for most honest Indians.
I have never seen.
1 second, professor, allow me. Remember one thing, sir. It's not about how you spend. No, there has to be politicians.
This level of fervor, I have never seen.
Professor.
Only post-emergency, I have seen this.
Professor, 1 minute.
Arnav, you must allow...
Professor, please, I request you. The point is, why are we debating this? It is only because this is an austere Diwali for most people. By the way, dear viewers, we have a lot of calls coming up and I'm going to start taking calls in 20 to 30 seconds from now, beginning with our first caller. The point is this. I don't know where the politicians get their money from. I know that most of the money are unknown donors. I don't believe, like most Indians don't believe, that the money comes from unknown donors. The money comes from known donors who may want to be unknown. And I say tonight, let all political parties take money from known donors and declare taxes on it and go for all the obvious rules and regulations that every Aam Aadmi expects. You know, this country is not exactly bursting at the seams in terms of its economy. Maybe the Sensex is. So I think politicians should be careful about splurge on all sides. I think the Aam Aadmi Party wanted to come in. I go back to Dr. Kumar Vishwas. Before that, an allegation was made by Sabir Ali. But
Arnav, I have not had a chance.
I'm coming to you after Kumar Vishwas. Kumar Vishwas, please.
गर्व और प्रसन्नता के साथ कहना चाहता हूँ कि 91% से ज़्यादा पैसा, चाहे छोटा पैसा मिला है हमें 17 करोड़, वो चेक से है या ऑनलाइन है? केवल 8 point something है जो कैश से मिला है, जिसकी रसीदें काटी गई हैं। और मैं जानता हूं पूरा न्यूज आवर बीत जाएगा, तू तू मैं हो जाएगी, ये किसी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी का लीडर ये नहीं कहेगा कि आज के बाद से हम आरटीआई के अंडर में आना चाहते हैं आज के बाद से। और संजय झा नए नए अभी अभी आए हैं पार्टी में, पहले वो पार्टी का पीछे से प्रचार करते, उन्हें पता नहीं है 5 रुपए की मेंबरशिप से शुरू हुई थी कांग्रेस 5 पैसे, और 54 की मेंबरशिप का जुमला चलता था गांधी के जमाने में। आज इनके यहां 83.5% का पता ही नहीं है कि कहां पर है, इसलिए ये सब आपस में मिल मिलाकर एक कॉकस बना लेंगे और कोई नहीं आना चाहता है। हम छोटे से ही 17 करोड़ से ही 7 करोड़ से ही, लेकिन हम 1 रुपया भी नहीं लेंगे। और मैं आपके न्यूज आवर पर डिक्लेयर कर रहा हूं, जिस दिन अरविंद केजरीवाल और नेशनल एग्जीक्यूटिव इसका उल्टा कर देंगे, आई विल क्विट आप, मैं आम आदमी पार्टी छोड़ दूंगा, पॉलिटिक्स छोड़ दूंगा। ये संजय झा पे गट्स हो तो बोल के दिखाएं कि कांग्रेस नहीं दिखाएगी तो मैं पार्टी कर दूंगा। ये साइको फैंसी करके यहां तक पहुंचना और बहस में बोलना ये बहुत अलग बात होती है, और इस देश की सचमुच राजनीतिक शुचिता को बनाए रखने का प्रयास करना अलग बात होती है, जिसकी औकात भी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज के इन लीडर
कुमार विश्वास जी।
एक मिनट,
देख लें आप दूसरे को साइको फ्रेंड करते हैं, अपने घर को भी देख ले। आपने बहुत लगता नहीं है कि 25 साल से संघर्ष किया है आप अन्ना के सीने पे सवार होकर आपने एक साल में 17 करोड़ रुपया जमा कर लिया। बड़े दामन मत झाड़िए। अन्ना क्या आंदोलन में आए हुए पैसे का हिसाब आज तक आपने नहीं दिया। आज तक आपने अन्ना के आपने एक साल में इतना बड़ा पैसा जमा कर लिया। मैं कह रहा हूँ कि मैं आरटीआई के दायरे में आने को तैयार हूँ, बात करने से नहीं। आओ हकीकत पे सामने लोगों को सामना करें।
सबीर अली ये कई सारे यू सी द प्रॉब्लम इज
सामने सामना
प्रॉब्लम
अन्ना के आंदोलन में आए हुए पैसे को दबा के बैठ कर राजनीति करोगे नहीं चलेगा।
एक मिनट सवाल पूछना चाहता हूँ मैं। एक मिनट दिल्ली में वन मिनट प्लीज सबीर अली जी
सबसे ज्यादा बड़ा
सबीर अली जी लेट मी आस्क यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑफ यू पीपल वांट टू फाइट लाइक दिस देन यू नो यू डोंट नीड मी, प्लीज लेट मी कम इनटू द डिबेट, प्लीज आई रिक्वेस्ट यू जी।
Arnab, this one minute debate is not a great idea. I can see that.
One minute. The JDU representative is asking the Aam Aadmi Party representative a few questions. First of all, right now, you said they collected 70 crores. I want to know, you have their funds with them?
I don't have funds. I am the BJP president.
How do you know they have 70 crores?
No, because they have collected.
Who told you?
Who told you?
Name the person.
As a president.
Say name the person.
I can give you the numbers. More than 200 people.
Who is the person?
I don't have right now.
Call up the person right now and show me. Tell me the person you called right now.
I'm not sitting with a mobile here.
No, tell me. Then why are you throwing charges at them? The point I'm making to you is...
I'm giving you the evidence.
No, where is it?
I'm ready. I'm confessing.
You're not giving.
I'll give you the numbers, telephone numbers. I'll make you speak in front of the camera. I'm the Delhi person. President, I'm just going door to door, and they are claiming they have given the money in cash.
You see, all of you people make these charges.
I have the evidence.
You know how to handle a
I have the evidence.
One second. Second question is, how much money? One of our viewers has sent a question to me, which he wants me to ask you. Can I please? And by the way, I'm opening up to the first caller in a minute. Manoj is my viewer, and he says, how much has your party, ask the JDU representative, how much money did his party spend on Patna and the Delhi Adhikar rally?
I was there charged. 8 lakh rupees.
8 lakh rupees?
Yes.
8 lakh rupees.
8 lakh rupees. I spent it.
Why are you laughing?
Come, I was there. I was in charge. It was my money.
It was your money?
It is my money.
Your money?
Yes. It is tax paid money. It is my money.
General
Vyas came by walking. Mr. People came by walking. More than 4 lakhs people in Bihari.
Can I tell you one thing? I have some facts. Hiring them. 1 minute. You see, the problem is. The problem is every political party has a standard line. People come to our rallies because they love our leader.
No.
And 1 minute, please let me complete. Can I be allowed to complete a sentence? It's a Friday evening. Everybody comes to our rally because they love our leader and everybody else pays money. Ab maine kuch figures nikale the ek news report se. Isme kaha jata hai ki the rent of a bus between two districts is 15,000 a day, which means if you take 2,000 buses, that will be 3 crores. Then there are 7,500 small vehicles for ferrying participants within the city. Then there are private helicopters. There are private planes. I don't know how many countless SUVs are there. And then there are 10,000 volunteers. इसके अलावा जो मुझे पता चला था कि एक रैली हुई थी सितंबर में जिसमें 1,000 रसोई थे. There were 1,000 cooks putting रसोईये. Sorry for my Hindi. Kumar Vishwas will correct me. Which means, if you look at the food bill only, the food bill comes to 2.5 to 3 to 4 crores. No, so I don't know. You had an austere rally. I don't know what you had a different kind of.
I had a different rally. Totally different rally.
Different, totally. Every party has a totally
no,
different
no, not
rally.
At all.
Our see, first caller tonight. No. Our first call. Let's see whether the
every
viewers.
Every party had a different rally.
Let's see whether the it viewers was. Accept this. Our first caller is from Chandigarh tonight. Good evening. Naresh is from Chandigarh. Naresh, go ahead. Who's your question to?
Good evening, Arnav. This is Naresh. I have a question. I do not have a question. I am just want to say that this is a sad day for democracy. I am sad to see this condition of my country when if there is something against any single party, every other party will start firing on that. If it is a common interest like RTI or anything, everybody will be on side.
That's the point. That's the point, Mr. Jadeja. You know, I agree. That's why I'm asking the question. You point as many fingers at each other. Mr. Narasimha Rao, you point as many fingers. Everybody fight with each other. But first clean up your own house, no? Tell us where you're all getting your money from. Then you fight, Mr. Narasimha Rao. But you're not doing that. Finger pointing like this doesn't make any sense.
Let me give you the perspective. When NDA was in power, I think the attempt was made, the law was amended to allow political donations to be treated as expenditure for corporate bodies. But unfortunately, even after that, this was done mainly to bring transparency in funding of elections, in funding of political parties. But even then, I think there has not been much change in the manner in which donors give their money. A large number of them do not want to be identified.
So don't take the money.
Want them to be
don't take the money.
For reasons their own interest.
Oh, wonderful excuse.
We have thousands of them who said they do not want to be identified by the government. And they refused that money. They said we are not going to take any penny.
This is not small money. This is big money. Thousands of crores of rupees. What are you saying? Our next caller.
Arnab,
the money is also
collected in very small amounts.
What
I think
small?
I can tell you in Gujarat, for the election, under Dhandan program, money was collected in very small amounts. In hundreds, in 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 500.
Sir, I am asking you because Modi had claimed earlier about the over 1,000 crores spent on Sonia Gandhi's foreign trips. And he had said, when Congress party says, why are you asking these questions? He has said, and I quote, in October 1st, 2012, we said, is it a crime to ask the government to disclose their spending? Was it right on my part to ask that question? Now, it can be argued that Narendra Modi was talking about...
People have a right to question.
No.
Absolutely. I think questions will be asked. So this public money is spent on private...
So this money also, you see... No, 1 minute. This
details will be sought.
Mr. Rao, this money also, no, the thousands of crores with which you feed people, you give people, as somebody said on one of my shows recently, we give liquor bottles because we are forced to. This money could also have been spent to feed a child, to build a house, you know, to spend on education. Can we afford this kind of an election?
You tell me, where do political parties get money to run their affairs? How do they conduct, how do they fight elections?
Depends on how you want to conduct their affairs.
Will media pay people?
The Aam Aadmi Party.
How will people Aam Aadmi Party says genuine expenditure?
Aam Aadmi
Aam Aadmi Party says
even 10 rupees I'll give you a receipt.
It has to come from donors. We don't have a system of state funding.
So declare your donors. No, why are you hiding them?
Political parties have been.
Why are you hiding them? I want to know the names of your donors,
Arnav,
so that tomorrow, if you oblige them, I don't want to hide them.
If people give small donations, or if they don't want their names to be disclosed, nothing can be done about it.
Next caller on is Vikram, and Vikram is calling in from. Vikram is our next caller, and Vikram is calling from Pune, I think.
Debate,
one sec.
And there has been a demand for it for many decades.
Somehow, we have not made progress
in that direction.
Our next caller.
People would want to know how political parties spend their money. You also have to
I don't want to know how you spend your money. I actually want to know, but more than that, I want to know how you get your money. That's all. who gives you the money. Our next caller is Vikram from Pune. Vikram, good evening.
Hi, Arnav.
Hi, you're watching this debate, Vikram. What do you think? You know, which side are you on? And do you have a question?
Oh, this is a funny debate. The best solution is that they should go under RTI.
Exactly.
But in the interim, if Mr. Kapil Sibal has any evidence of use of black money, then it is his moral duty to inform the income tax department, file a case against Mr. Modi, instead of going on a rhetoric and taking a press conference.
That's a point tonight. Yeah, I think Sanjay should answer that. Sanjay, then this is not,
I'll answer that. Vikram, thanks for
the mark.
Now, Vikram, thanks for asking the question. The answer is very simple, and the point has been actually debated today. Let me make it very easy for you. Mr. Narendra Modi made a lot of allegations. He didn't just ask a question. He made a lot of allegations on Mrs. Gandhi's medical expenditure when she went abroad for treatment. And we gave an answer. The government gave an answer. The party gave an answer because he had allegations of all sorts. By the same logic, when Mr. Kapil Sibal... No, 1 minute. When Mr. Kapil Sibal asked a question about what is happening in terms of the expenditures of the Bharatiya Janata Party, let me tell you, the BJP needs to explain your own arithmetic of taking certain heads of expenditure, whether it's cooking, whether it's transport, whether it's accommodation, etc., raises a big question mark because this is a real multi-crore expenditure project. So the BJP needs to explain that because the principal point here is this, that they actually the other day raised money from an ordinary person attending the rally and said that they wanted to donate the rally for a relief cause.
Sanjay, 1 minute.
Sanjay,
you know
where is the money coming from?
Sanjay Jha,
remember this debate. I'm saying this debate is as big as the debate on the ordinance. I don't know if you sense it. I'm sensing the anger in the calls tonight. This debate is as big a debate as the ordinance. You know, it's not just about, we don't want corrupt politicians convicted politicians in the parliament. We are in our legislative bodies. We also want to know where your money is coming from because you know why? Everybody's not making money on the Sensex. There are a lot of honest Indians out there who are calling tonight. And Indra from Mumbai is calling tonight. Listen to Indra from Mumbai. Indra, good evening. Indra, good evening.
Mr. Goswami.
Good evening, Mr. Kishlu.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
My question is to all the parties, like if they are they don't have any business to call pinpoint fingers on other parties if they don't want to come under the RTI.
Exactly. I think Krishan from Mumbai, Mr. Kichlu, thank you for calling, and all our viewers, I'm wishing you a happy Diwali. And you know, people, it's not a very prosperous Diwali. Mr. Krishan is calling from Delhi. 1 second, so many callers. Let me take a few. Mr. Krishan, good evening. What's your point?
Mr. Goswami, good evening.
Good evening.
I have a question for Mr. Jha.
No, Mr. Jha. Yes, please. Go ahead.
If they have Mr. Sibal is the Jha minister, he could have easily passed a law and gone into RTI. He didn't accept that. Now, what is the authority he has to question BJP or any other party?
Okay, fine. Mr. Krishan, thank you very much for your call. Sanjay, you heard that. The point has been made before. Aam Aadmi Party coming in 4 minutes into the debate. I'm going to Professor Vaidyanathan. Yeah. Professor Vaidyanathan, you seem to be getting some support.
Let me give him a quick answer.
Okay, quick answer to Mr. Krishan from Sanjay Jaffa.
It is the Congress Party-led UPA. It is a Congress Party-led UPA that brought in the game-changing, transparent law called the Right to Information Act, which has empowered the common man of India and people like you and me. So let's give credit where it's due. The intention of this party and the government is to be more transparent and accountable. Point number two, as far as the issue of RTI and political parties is concerned, let me tell you that any donation or any contribution made to the party, which is in excess of ₹20,000 on a transaction, it has to be disclosed to the Election Commission. Political parties file income tax returns. So, and everything is available, by the way, on the website. Now, the challenge lies in that some political parties.
While saying all
one
this.
Point, Adam, some political parties, including the left. Now, listen, I'm speaking from the Congress, but I can also tell you that parties from the left, I've heard them over the debate several months. They say that they get a lot of, you know, disaggregated numbers from multiple sources of small, you know, denominations in villages and rural areas that they cannot afford a receipt for. Now, this has had a political consensus. For the first political parties were on the same.
Sanjay Jha.
Let me tell you, I agree with you completely that if there's any black money, you know, it should not be there in the system. Cash should not be accepted
by any
party.
Two things to you. 1 minute. Two points to you. Sanjay Jha says tonight our intention. 1 minute. He uses the word our intention. I tell you, Mr. Sanjay Jha, India does not want intention. India wants action. That's point number one. Don't tell me that you had the right intention. The second thing is you can't talk about the RTI if you don't use the RTI on yourself. The best test of the RTI will be the day that you use the RTI on yourself. No. You must first regulate. And third point is, going by your logic, both the BJP and the Congress get no money from a big corporate house. Because everybody who's giving them money is giving them 5,000, 10,000, 500, 200. Now, do the people watching the News Hour tonight, this question goes to you, believe that no big corporate houses do big funding of political parties and all the money that comes small?
A donation, it will have to be in the corporate's balance sheet. It'll have to be in the corporate's annual report and the P&L.
If it is,
if it makes a donation to a political party above that,
if it is
a small number of 20,000, it has to be in the corporate if they have shareholders. And if they're transparent, it has to be there.
I'm going across to Professor Vaidyanathan for a rebut on that. Professor Vaidyanathan's been wanting to come in for a long time.
You see, there is an excellent report by Pranab Mukherjee. When he was finance minister, he presented to parliament on black money and its impact on political system. I wish this government had acted at least 10% of that report, in which case we may not be having this debate today.
There is already an anti-money laundering legislation, Mr. Vaidyanathan. There is already an anti-money laundering legislation. Banks have been told on how to know your customer.
No, yes.
There is already a whistleblower bill. There are multiple steps being taken to prevent corruption by this government.
You may not know what I am talking about. No, you may not know what
I am
talking about.
They will learn all the time in this 2020 WWF they are playing for last 6-7 years in this country.
No, let me tell you an interesting statistic. If I go by the logic here, I want to share a very interesting statistic. The CPI has 57% of its total income from donations above 20,000. Which means 43% is below 20,000. In other words, the Communist Party of India has the maximum number of rich donors. Can you believe that? And the BJP and the Congress Party don't have rich donors. The BJP and the Congress Party only have small donors. Now, I don't know what is going on
both
here.
Both of them are below poverty line.
Arnab, the Congress Party has got a deep historical reach all over the country. It is the only true national party in India.
No, that's all right. You don't need to give yourself a certificate on that. No, the question is, how many 1 minute on the debate. Tell me, where does the money for private helicopters and private planes come from? Sabir Ali, let's go direct.
That's why I'm talking, at least you gave a chance. I'm just asking. I'll give you one example. In Gujarat, there is one company called Adani. In 10 years, he's grown from 100 crores to 1 lakh crore. He has all...
No, but my point to you is your political party. You're a businessman.
Exactly. I can tell you one thing.
So much information available.
It is. Anybody can check it. I'm not saying. I've said it so many times. I have already said so many times. I said, if you have any objections, come go to the court against me. It is on the record.
No, I
can tell you. It is, regarding you as the helicopter.
You have sucked up to UPA to protect yourself and your leader.
I have never done it.
And change the track.
You can't talk about this money. Where is coming from?
How much of your money comes from? How much of your money is from named sources and how much from anonymous?
As a president, I can say at least today more than 90% we have all the records.
No, not records. I want your records. Give me your records. Where are your records?
You have not said to browse.
Is it on the website? Is it on the website?
We have not put it on the website, but we are going to put it.
No, you are going to put it. When will you put it?
We are ready.
1 minute. This is the moment. 1 minute.
Now we are ready to come under RTI.
The JDU.
We are ready to come under RTI. Let them move the bill. We are ready.
You are ready to come under the RTI?
Why not?
You're the okay.
We are ready to come.
And you are going to put your accounts on the website.
Exactly, we are going to put.
When?
It will take little time.
How much time?
How I can come?
You said
right
you have.
Just put after 1 week. I'll give you on the answer if you want to come on the record.
After 1 week, you'll put it on the website.
I didn't say that. I said you keep this debate.
Now that's where you begin to dodge.
Not dodge. See, you can't put this kind of words to me.
The question.
I'm saying keep this debate after 1 week. I'll give you the time.
I just want to know and you.
Otherwise, give me a call after 2 weeks. I'll give you the time.
You. I don't want the time, Mr. Sabir Ali.
I'm ready here.
Time.
Not. I'm giving the time.
I simply want
to
know.
You are going to come.
I simply want to know where you're going to get your money from.
We are ready to publish on the website.
To all my guests on the News Hour tonight, I don't think India knows the source of funds. We need to know the source of funds because that's the only way to clean up the system. But one thing is clear
here. Public funding.
Public funding is one thing. Till then, some austerity will also be good.
You cannot. The political parties. Political parties can be treated as public authorities only if you give them enough money to run their own efforts.
Your accountability.
I think it's bizarre to expect Arna, political BJP parties to run all their efforts.
I think it is.
We have thousands of people visiting daily.
The only solution is
we are afraid to give you money because this government can exclude us. But we are saying we are not receiving any cash, so much of cash. Agar aap check de sakte to dijiye. And we are the only party of this country jo keh rahe hain corporate se paise nahi lenge. Mr. Birla ne Aditya.
Come on, you won't exist after Delhi elections.
Aur 36 crore Congress.
On the debate tonight. I promise you. Like we followed the issue of the ordinance. Like we followed the debate on the ordinance. This debate, I assure you, has only begun here on Times Now. Next, we will investigate. Then we will expose. And then we'll come and debate again. So thank you, gentlemen. This is only day one.
Yes, we welcome
I wish
you
a great weekend and a happy Diwali. I see you soon. Maybe next time with all your accounts in your hands. Thank you very much for joining me tonight.